Hey guys, welcome to my channel Desi Abroad. And as you know, I have been living in Thailand for the past 3 years. And in this video, I will be discussing with you about the cost of living in Thailand and whether a basic salary of 30,000 baht is enough for all of you to live comfortably here in Thailand. Before we continue, make sure you subscribe to my channel and click on that bell icon to get notifications about my video. Also, I would love to hear from you guys about what you think about my videos. So make sure you leave a comment below so I can learn more about what you guys have to say. So moving back to the topic. So what are the expenses that you should be expecting if you're planning on moving to Thailand or you are coming here for a couple of months? One very important thing that all of you guys need to know is that we all have different lifestyles. So it depends completely on you yourself, how much you want to spend or what you want to do with the finances that you have. But that does not mean that you should not watch this video, because this video is going to help you on knowing what to expect and what kind of expenses that you can look forward to once you are in Thailand. First, let's talk about the most important thing and your major expense here in Thailand. Well, you guessed it. It is accommodation. So we're going to start by talking about accommodation. Right here in Thailand, I am living in a condo for which I personally am paying 8,500 baht. And if you want to learn about my condo, you can probably click the link above right here, I'm guessing, to see the video related to the condo that I made. So moving forward, I pay 8,500 baht for the condo that I'm living, and it is amazing. I really like the place where I live. So in the surrounding, you can see in the background, this is the place that I am staying right now. So within 8,500 baht, it has a pool, there's a fitness center, good security, and also the internet is also included within this price. But again, it depends on you what kind of accommodation you're looking for and what is your budget on that point as well. I have a few friends who are staying here in Thailand and paying only 4,000 baht for a basic accommodation. And then there are those who are paying 50,000 baht a month to live a bit more lavishing lifestyle. With getting an accommodation, you need to look forward to paying for the electricity and the water expenses as well. Now, sometimes they are included within the rent, but in my own personal experience, that only happens with short-term rentals, not if you're planning on living here long-term. I pay on an average 1500 Thai baht for electricity, and majority of the time when I'm home, my aircon is running. For you, if you use less aircon and majority of the time you're not home, you can expect to pay less, around 800 to 1000 Thai baht. And for the water expenses, the water is really cheap here. I pay around 300 baht a month for the monthly water usage. Now, a friend pointed out to me that you're paying actually too much. There might be a leakage, a pipe leakage in your room, because it usually comes up to around 100 Thai baht. So might be less for you. Then the other most important expense that you should be looking forward to is the food. I myself am a very foodie person and I enjoy eating a lot of different cuisines. So in Thailand, you can find food from literally anywhere around the world, and even Thai food itself is so delicious. Funny thing that I have noticed here in Thailand is that it's comparatively cheaper if you're planning on just cooking or making basic meals. It's actually cheaper to buy cooked meal from outside rather than cooking at your own home. In other words, it's cheaper not to cook here in Thailand. But because I love my wife's cooking and my wife enjoys cooking a lot, so we do cook at home quite often. We spend on an average about 6,000 to 7,000 Thai baht on food, but it can easily come down if you do not indulge yourself in foods like pizza, burgers, and going to fancy restaurants quite often. If you just go to a normal restaurant here in Thailand, you can easily pay less. Now, just to give you a general idea, over here in Thailand, a basic meal will cost you around 40 to 60 baht per meal, which is very cheap. Now, Let's talk about transportation. I'm very sure that once you come to Thailand, you will not have your own transportation, and also it's quite close to impossible to arrange any transportation in advance when you're coming here in Thailand. But there is an application called Grab, which is just like Uber, which quite a lot of people over here in Thailand use on a regular basis to travel within the city or wherever they want to go. But over time, if you continuously use Grab, it is going to cost you a fortune. So there are also public transportations like buses that you can use. I myself have never used a bus over here, but if you are living in Bangkok, you can use the BTS or MRT train services over there, which are used by quite a lot of people on a daily basis. But what majority of the tourists, travelers, or people living here for a long time do is that they rent motorbikes. Now, renting a motorbike on a monthly basis is not that expensive. It can cost you around 2,000 to 3,000 baht a month. And after that, the only thing you need to worry about is your fuel cost. But if you rent a motorbike on a daily basis, it's going to cost you around 200 to 300 baht per day. But on a monthly basis, it's around 2,000 to 3,000 baht a month. Very cheap, in my personal opinion. Now, the fuel cost for the bike that you have rented is going to be around 800 to 1,000 baht a month. Again, fuel comparatively here is cheap, and also the motorbikes give you a good mileage as well. Many of the apartments over here or condos might offer you a shared internet service. Now, the shared internet service is going to be slow compared to your own service. So if you want to have a fast-paced internet used for multiple things like watching movies and all that for your own, you can get a good internet service, for example, from AIS, costing you around 600 Thai baht a month. Moving over to entertainment. Now, being in Thailand, I'm very sure you just don't want to work all the time, but you want to hang out with your friends, experience the nightlife, and lavish yourself in some amazing, delicious meals by going to some fancy restaurants. So let's assume that you plan on hanging out with your friends or experiencing the nightlife or indulging yourself in lavishing meals at least once a week. And let's say it costs you around 1,000 to 1,500 Thai baht per week when you go out for your own entertainment. So you can expect a reduction of at least 4,000 to 6,000 Thai baht in your bank account. In my personal opinion, that is actually a lot, and you can actually have more fun in much cheaper cost. So I'm just giving you an average of what could be, but like I said, it completely depends on you, how you want your entertainment over here to be like. And of course, let's not forget about one very important thing, that once you're in Thailand, there are going to be days you're going to feel lonely, you just want to stay home and chill, or you just want to have some entertainment or generally being bored. In this case, I highly recommend for you to get a Netflix subscription over here in Thailand. It's only going to cost you around 350 baht a month, and it's going to keep you busy during those times when you have nothing to do. Now, phone is one of the most important things that you need for your daily communication over here in Thailand and around the world as well. Now, there are a number of mobile service providers over here. The one I use is called True, and I am paying 399 a month for a package that they're offering. Within that package, I get a couple of hundred minutes call time for free, and I also get unlimited internet. So it's good. Finally, I'm going to add one more thing to the list of expenses that you can expect over here in Thailand, which is miscellaneous. Now, when I say miscellaneous, it's about things like toiletries, makeup, clothes, shoes, all those extra things that you might require on a monthly basis. So let's just say that costs you around 1,500 baht a month. Right, so you're putting 1,500 baht a month just for these extra expenses that might occur while you are here in Thailand. So finally, what is your total expense? So your total expense, that what you can expect to pay here in Thailand, is around 21,750 to 24,850 Thai baht, which roughly comes around to $700 to $800 a month. Now, also answering the same question at the same time, is 30,000 Thai baht enough to live comfortably here in Thailand? Yes, it definitely is. 30,000 baht is a really good salary. If you manage your finances really carefully, you can actually get to enjoy your life while you're here as well and get to save a little bit money on that point as well. So there you have it. The breakdown about all the expenses that might occur while you are over here in Thailand. Now, I'm going to say the same point again that I said before. It completely depends on you. You might be the kind of person who doesn't want to spend too much money, or you might be the kind of person whose pocket allows you to spend more money on different things, and you might have different lifestyle, you might have different requirements, but still, this is what you can expect here on a comfortable amount. So it's like an average amount. You can definitely go cheaper than this, and you can definitely go higher than this as well. So before I wrap up, make sure you subscribe to my channel, like this video, and I would love to hear what you guys have to say as well. So please do leave a comment below as well. So guys, stay safe, take care, and I will see you guys later. Bye-bye.